So, man. Let's hop into the top 15 Merle Schmaggergmosh.
Schmishmo.
Uncle Schmishmo. Number 15, Working Man Blues.
But I keep my nose on the grindstone, work hard every day. Get tired on the weekend. After I draw my pay, but I go back working. Come Monday morning, I'm right back with the crew. I drink a little beer that evening, sing a little bit of this working man blues.
He's got a lot of songs like this and like some other ones that we're going to talk about, where it's just, this is what a simple beer drinking country song should be like. Like, there's so many songs nowadays that are just like, let me list off all the nonsense words that I can about, you know, being country. This one, it just feels like he is actually singing about working people, for working people, and like kind of as a working person. Shit, he was going to jail so much back in the day that he was just like, he would work actual jobs and do labor and shit. And I just love the drink a little beer in taverns and sing some of them working man blues. It's just, beautiful.
I let the comments slide and I didn't really reply to it when we were talking with Jamie Lynn Wilson, and she said how pop music is for younger kids and like country's for older people, and so obviously now they're blending, so they're making country for younger people, and that's what I was thinking about. Like, people are like, well, there's always been drinking country songs. I'm like, yeah, but drinking country songs nowadays are about spring break, whereas drinking country songs back then were about you get done with your job and you go to a bar to relax and let the steam out of your
exactly apartment. And you worked hard all day and now you're gonna just, you know, like he says, have some beer at a tavern and just kind of decompress. It it's just, you know, and you could say that I'm being hypocritical. It's like, oh, it's just because it's Merle that whatever. I'm like, no, fuck you, it's great. I love it.
And it's like all of a sudden I point this out, I mean, it might be because we're suburbanites, but like country music, what's on the radio, it sounds like what rich white kids listen to, not hardworking blue-collar people.
Exactly. Country
not
music.
Not that hardworking blue-collar people don't listen to pop music.
Yeah,
I'm
country
sure
music nowadays, the modern shitty pop music is
sorority country.
It's what a rich person thinks that poor people would want to hear.
Yeah.
But it's not actually what they want to hear.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, it's just shit, and Merle Haggard's better.
Fuck yeah.
Next is number 14, Today I Started Loving You Again.
Today I started loving you again. I'm right back where I've really always been. I got over you just long enough to let my heartache mend. Then today I started loving you again. What a fool I was to think I could.
Good old.
I wrote this song
breaker
for you, Kevin. No, I do like it because I don't know if I've heard the song. I've heard a shit ton of Merle songs, but I forgot about this one before listening to it again today. And I was like, forgot how fucking amazing of a heartbreak song this is.
Oh, yeah. It's just where he's talking about how he finally got over her just long enough so that the feeling of loving her could come back in and just wreck him completely. Yeah. And it's just like, oof, that's powerful.
Yeah, because, I mean, everyone's had that feeling of where you're like, it's like the early stage of getting over someone where you're like, I'm over them, but then someone says their name and you're like, oh, God.
Exactly. That is what this song is about.
Yeah. It's so great. Next is 13, The Bottle Let Me Down.
Tonight, the bottle let me down. And let your memory come around. The one true friend I thought I'd found. Tonight the bottle let me down.
This is just another one of those classic, like, heartbreak type drinking songs. Hold on. I wanted to look up the lyrics because I remember there was one lyric in this song that I loved, but I forgot what it is because I'm an idiot.
Twice. Double idiot.
Oh, yeah, because it was the, it's like talking about how kind of like drink is not really helping. So it goes, the one true friend I thought I'd found tonight, the bottle let me down. Like, I just love that lyric.
That is a great line.
Which is, it's funny because I just realized that's like the opposite of that stupid fucking Luke Combs song, of beer never broke my heart or whatever. But
yeah.
But yeah, this is one of those that I just fucking love.
Oh, absolutely. It's a classic.
Yeah. Number 12, Okie from Muskogee.
And we don't make no party out of loving. We like holding hands and pitching woo. We don't let our hair grow long and shaggy. Like the hippies out in San Francisco do. And I'm proud to be an Okie from Muskogee. A place where even squares can have a ball. We still wave old glory down at the courthouse. And white lightning's still the biggest thrill of all. Hey, leather boots.
I was actually surprised you didn't have this on your top 10.
Well, so I was going to say, the reason I don't have it on my top is because it's too, the lyrics are too
specific.
Just being a goody-goody and like, you know, and like, oh. He's not really, like, I feel like the lyrics of this song aren't really genuine to who he was as a person and like how his whole career went. Especially, like, I love there was a quote. Someone asked him about it like years after this song, or he's just like, you say in that song, you know, you don't smoke marijuana in Muskogee. How do you feel about that now? He's just like, I don't spend too much time in Muskogee anymore. And so like, it's that kind of stuff where he's just like, you know, we don't do this, we don't do that. It's like, I get it. And I mean, it is a good song as a song, but like there's too much of the, we don't do all this stuff, because it's like, I don't want it to be like, we think we're so much better, because it seems like obviously the song is about like not being a fucking degenerate, but it's also like, okay, well, some of the things that you're harping on are kind of like, well, what's wrong with that? Like growing the hair too long, like, fuck it. Willie Nelson, your bro, has long braids and smokes all the time. Like, come on.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, or it's like, yeah, we don't grow our hair out like those hippies. It's like, you hang out with Willie.
And
Willie
you
has
live
the longest braid
in California.
Yeah.
Yeah, so that's really the only reason that I mean, also just because there's so many Merle songs that are great that it's kind of like it's slid down my, like, obviously I don't hate it at all. But it's slid down in terms of where I'd rank it on a top thing. It'd probably be top 20, but somewhere in there.
Yeah. Remind me that after we finish this top, I want to close on Merle again, because I want to talk about his legacy kind of after his death and how Nashville's shat on it.
And I would totally forget to remind you, but okay.
Yeah, I'll try to remember. But next is number 11, I Can't Be Myself.
I can't be myself and be what pleases you. And down deep inside, I don't believe that you'd want me to. And it's not my way to take so long deciding that I can't be myself when I'm with you.
I love this because it's kind of, you know, the if you've known Montgomery Gentry, like, She Couldn't Change Me type song, where it's this whole I can't be myself around you because you want to change this and that about me. And it's like, no, like I'm not changing.
But it's also got like a sadness to it.
Yeah, exactly.
Different than the Montgomery Gentry song.
Yeah, it's not like the sarcastic smug song. It's like I can't be myself.
Yeah, he's actually feeling, you know, introspective and down about his situation. Mm-hmm. It's like, oh, that's oof.
Yeah. Yeah, I love it. I don't have much else to say about that. I just remember I heard it today, and it wasn't even on my mind when I was thinking top 10, but I heard it. I was like, this is like a beautifully written song, like a really gorgeous type ballad. And so I was like, yeah, I got to add that one. But next is number 10, I'm a Lonesome Fugitive.
I'd like to settle down, but they won't let me. A fugitive must be a rolling stone. Down every road, there's always one more city. I'm on the run, the highway is my home.
Yeah, this is one that I was kind of briefly mentioning before, that he's got certain song types that he dips into that well multiple times.
Yeah.
And this is one where...
Like John Moreland in Oklahoma?
Oh, yeah. Well, and like we said earlier, he went to jail a fuck ton. And so he's got a lot of songs like this where he talks about, like, you know, being either, you know, wanted or being formerly, you know, now out of prison or being in prison. And so it's just one of those songs about how, you know, society... looks how they look at you when you are that kind of person, and like there's nothing you can do about it. And so like he's just a lonely human. And one of my favorite songs, which is going to be later on down the way, is one that I'll get into that a little bit more on, but
moron.
But it's a good song. That's what you get.
To the audience, I was very sick this weekend, and I have bad asthma and allergies, so those things just took effect when I got sick, so now I can't breathe.
Asmergies.
Yeah, I love it. Where are we at? Number 9, The Fight Inside of Me.
Yeah, walking on the fight inside of me. Running down with life, I'm fighting and fought to if you don't love it, leave it. Let this song I'm singing be a warning. You're running down my country, man. You're walking on the fight inside me.
This was the one I was kind of referring to quickly when we were talking about the veteran one earlier. That fact is, I love this because it's this awesome conservative type, proud to be an American type song, but it's not hokey.
Yes.
Like they're like, if you listen to like Toby Keith's Angry America, Courtesy of the Red, White, and Blue, whatever, or like American Made or what, Made in America.
Yeah.
Like,
don't get me wrong. Songs, I love those songs.
Oh yeah. I do. Yes. But they're so hokey. Whereas this is like an actual, like, good song. Like, it's not over the top, but it's like a proud to be an American type song.
Exactly. He's acknowledging that there's this side to him that exists, and it exists in a lot of people. And when people, you know, like he says, you're stepping on the fight inside of me, like he's talking about how, like, you're not recognizing that this exists, this patriotism and this desire to fight for what we believe in. Like, that's not gonna go away. It's part of us, and it's really cool.
Yeah. I love this song. It's America. Number 8, I don't know if you'll hate me for adding this one, but The Way I Am.
The way I am don't fit my shackles. The way I am, reality, I can almost see that barber dancing. I just dream, keep on being the way I am.
Oh, I certainly will not. I didn't have it on mine, did I? I don't
No.
Yeah, I literally only didn't put it on there because of the fact that it's also Cody Jinx recorded it later, way later, and I really love Cody Jinx's version, and so I end up listening to the Jinx version a lot more.
Yeah, well, because I also knew because you probably wouldn't, because the how like I did, I'm Not the Devil was one of my favorites by Cody Jinx, but you like the Warwick Davis one more.
Yes.
So I knew you'd probably do that because you probably like the Cody Jinx version better than this
exactly.
one.
Exactly. And it's like absolutely nothing against Merle. Obviously, he's tremendous and it's his song, so that's also why it's amazing. But yeah, I just, when I hear Jinx sing it, I just like it a little better. And so I listen to that version better. But it's a great fucking song.
What I like about this one, though, is that it does sound like Cody Jinx just does the song justice. Because, it sounds the same just sung by Merle Haggard, whereas, like, the biggest one I think of is Mental Revenge by Waylon, where there are two different sounding songs, his and Jamie Johnson's. They're completely different sounding. But this one, it just sounds like Cody Jinx on stage was like, let's just sing this Merle song.
Yes, we'll make it sound the way that he did it, which I think is great. But, yeah, I love this song. It, you know, talks about, you know, not being happy in life, just like with your job and just the way that you're doing things, and just like daydreaming for just being out and like fishing on a riverbank. It's just, I really dig it. And it's just, and he, you know, Merling it up.
Merle, Durl and Merle. Number 7, If We Make It Through December.
If we make it through December, everything's gonna be all right, I know. It's the coldest time of winter, and I shiver when I see the falling snow. If we make it through December, got plans to be in a warmer town come summertime. Maybe even California. If we make it through December, we'll be fine.
This is about Y2K.
if the robots don't attack, we will have made it.
I like it because it's a Christmas song, kind of.
You shut your face. No, it's because I think, I'm pretty sure, I mean, I could be wrong because I'm an idiot and my brain is tired, but I'm pretty sure it's a thing that would not exist nowadays for most people to even comprehend. But he's talking about, like, if we make it through December in the, like, literal survival winter is coming kind of sense. And, like, they have to do things, and, like, because he does reference, like, Christmas and, like, having, you know, being able to afford things for the children and family or whatever.
Yeah.
And like all that stuff, but it's just like hardship on top of the fact that you're just like literal surviving.
Yeah, exactly. And it's fantastic. Number 6, Branded Man.
I'd like to hold my head up and be proud of who I am, but they won't let my secret go untold. I paid the debt I owed them, but they're still not satisfied. Now I'm a branded man out in the cold.
This song is about joining a fraternity and just branding those letters right on your back.
Fraternities in the South. This is what I was referring to when we were talking about Lonesome Fugitive. But this song I really love, and it's just, he just talks about how, you know, after being out of prison, he just has that brand on him forever. And so, like, if you try to find work or do anything and you say that you're an ex-con, it's just everyone looks at you differently. And so, like, the line about, like, I'd like to hold my head up and be proud of who I am, but then everyone's just, like, always trying to keep him down. And it's just a really interesting song about how, like, people want to judge me and they don't even fucking know me. And, like, I can't even be proud of doing anything anymore because of the way that the world is looking at me. I think it's a really neat song.
Yeah, it's a fantastic song. Number 5 is one we've talked about before on this podcast, is Misery and Gin.
But here I am again, mixing mixing misery and gin, sitting with all my friends and talking to myself. I look like I'm having a good time, but any fool can tell that this honky-tonk heaven really makes you feel like hell.
I love it. It's very sad. About, well, misery and gin. From the title, you can tell that it's about being sad and drinking.
Kevin, it's a song about his favorite movie and alcohol beverage.
Yes, I very much enjoy the breaking of kneecaps and the alcohol gin.
Yeah. Gin is disgusting. And anyone who says different is wrong. You are wrong. It is bad. Except for the one time... I don't know if I told the story on the podcast, but there was the time in college when I was quite, I don't know if you guys know this. I was quite an alcoholic in college. I was like tired from work, I think, because I think it was when I was living out there. I had graduated, but I was still out of the lease, so I was just working out there. And I got done working. I was tired, so I was like, I'm just going to do some Red Bull vodkas to wake up because I need to wake up so I can go out and drink because I have to drink because alcohol. Any day that ends in Y, I was drinking in college. That's not a lie, people. I'm not up talking myself. I was an alcoholic in college. But I remember I bought New Amsterdam and Red Bull. I was like, there we go, Red Bull vodkas, let's do it. Get home, realize I bought New Amsterdam gin and not vodka, but Red Bull gin. Actually, not the worst thing I've ever had.
Well, it's also because Red Bull is such an aggressive flavor that it kind of drowns everything else out.
Yeah, exactly. I was like, I don't recommend it to people. I wouldn't say do that instead of Red Bull vodka, but it wasn't bad.
Yep.
But gin is not good.
No thanks. But being sad and listening to this song is good.
Yes. Gotta listen to the sad songs to make you feel sadder.
Yeah, but I think my favorite song is... My favorite line is where he just, you know... Says, here I am again, drinking misery and gin, you know, I can't think of the line because my brain is broken, but he says, he's in a crowded bar full of people, but, you know, around with all my friends and talking to myself. He's just by himself, sad in his own little world.
Yeah. And, all right, into our top four. If you don't know these four songs, you've just failed as a country music
fuck
fan.
You.
Number four is Sing Me Back Home.
Let him sing me back home. Song I used to hear and make my old memories come alive and take me away and turn back the years and sing me back home before I die. I recall last Sunday morning.
I fucking love this song.
Yeah. Another one about the prison and the prison. And
it's just so, it's so great because it's just like marching down that kind of aisle of Dead Man Walking. And he just goes, one last thing. Please let my guitar friend sing me this song. And it's just this gorgeous song about a guy who knows he's going to his death, but he's just like, I just want to hear this song one more time.
Yeah, I love it where he just, you know, sing me back home, because at least in his head he can be free for a brief moment.
Yeah, it's fantastic. These top four, it was impossible to choose kind of which one went where in my list, because this is my top four of my list.
Four.
not in this order, but this. But I'm happy either way. Number three is I Think I'll Just Stay Here and Drink.
Could be holding you tonight. Could quit doing wrong, start doing right. You don't care about what I think. I think I'll just stay here and drink. Hey, button you down, don't square no deal. Least you know the way I feel. Take all the money in the bank.
think I'd just stay here and drink. Listen close and you can hear that loud jukebox playing in my ear. Ain't a woman gonna change the way I think. I think I'd just stay here and drink.
This song is great because of the lyrics and because of the jamness. After every verse, this, it just has the saxophone solos and
this
stuff.
This is the country drinking song.
Oh, yeah. Like, oh, yeah.
The country drinking song. And it is so tremendous. I would have to say this is probably the Merle song I have listened to most, if I had to guess.
I mean, we've thrown this song on thousands of times, being
so
up in Hayward on the jukebox
everything. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. 100%. And, like, I even love the cover by Jason Cassidy on his album.
Oh, yeah, his version is very good.
Yeah. I
but
mean,
the original is just, oh,
yeah,
perfection.
Yeah, so great. So if you don't know, this lyrics themselves are like, I should be home with this girl who I kind of got in a fight, and she's like, I think I'll just stay here and drink. And it's just like,
exactly.
It's such a great, I mean, now it's kind of a cliche of sitting at a bar drinking all your pains, but this was not an unoriginal comment or lyric at the time, and it's so great. Number three,
two.
I'm looking at the wrong
two. God damn it!
I was looking at my list, and I was looking at your list. I was like, Brandon, man, no, we already talked about that. Number two, Mama Tried.
I turned 21 in prison, doing life without parole. No one could steer me right, but Mama tried. Mama tried, Mama tried to raise me better, but her pleading I denied. That leaves only me to blame, 'cause Mama tried.
This was my number one, because I think this is one of the greatest country songs ever written. But I'm not upset with our number one.
Yeah.
But this song, if you don't know Mama Tried, what is wrong with you?
Yeah, you have to have tried your very best to never hear anything ever.
This song is mentioned in every fucking song ever written by any other country artist after 1982, or I don't know when the song came out, but after this fucking song came out.
This is one of those songs that, like, so many people, as soon as it fucking starts with, I turned 21 in prison, everyone's like, let's go.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
It's just fucking so
and it's
great.
And it's such a Merle song of just like, my mama tried to raise me right. She really tried, but I just didn't do it. I refused to listen. Like,
And then it just, what he comes back to, like, well, you know, it's only me that's left to blame because mama tried. Like, she tried
Mama tries to raise me better.
Yeah. It's just beautiful. Yeah. To start with, turned 21 in prison doing life without parole. It's just like, all right,
But the greatest homage to this fucking song is Keith Urban's.
I will fight you through the fucking internet. I will find a way, and I will strangle you to death with that fucking microphone.
Obviously, totally kidding. If you guys don't know, fucking Keith Urban released some shitty fucking pop song where he used
what a surprise.
The infamous guitar, like, this is one of the most infamous guitar riffs in country music ever.
Oh, yeah.
If not the most infamous country riff.
Because it's tremendous.
Just that
wow.
And just hearing fucking Keith Urban butt fuck that song. It angers
God,
me so
it
much.
Makes I can't even talk about it. I'm just too angry.
The best use of it in another song, though, is the Overnight Success by Zane Williams, where it's just like,
oh, yeah.
Buddy, teach, learn how to play guitar, learn a few Haggard lit riffs, and it just.
Absolutely.
But yeah, number one is by far Kevin's favorite song by him, Jingle Bells.
Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way.
I will kill you.
Number one is fine. Silver bells.
Silver bells. Silver bells. It's Christmas time.
I knew you were going to do it. I didn't even try to get upset because I knew you were going to do it.
Silver wings.
Silver wings.
in the sunlight, roaring engines headed somewhere in flight. They're taking you away and leaving me lonely. Silver wings slowly fading out of sight. Don't leave me, I cry.
I hate Christmas music. Okay, Silver Wigs. Yeah, this is my favorite Merle song for sure. It's just I don't know. It's just got all the feeling and the sound of like what I want from a classic country song, and then it's got the heartbreak. And it's just about him, you know, looking at planes. It's kind of like Watching Airplanes by Gary.
I was gonna
Allen.
Say, I wonder if that song. I mean, had to have been inspired by this, but I need to look at those lyrics and see if he like referred to this song at all.
Yeah, because he's, you know, he's watching planes, you know, watch the plane fly away, and he's just like thinking about how his lady who's leaving him is flying away, and just,
and the silver wings are taking her away.
Exactly. And yeah, it's just, he's just sad.
And it makes it kind of almost angelic in a way. It's like,
yeah, it's really, I think it's just a really nice song. I just love it.
This song was number 3 on my list, because I had Sing Me Back Home and Mama Tried above it.
Tremendous. And that's the thing with like any legend that we do, you know, after this, it's just an embarrassment of riches with the songs that they have. It's unbelievable.
I know. Yeah, it's going to be impossible to do like down the road when we do Waylon and Johnny Cash and Willie and all. These are going to be very difficult episodes to get
absolutely
top 10s for. And yeah, that's our top 15 Merle Haggard songs. Oh.